The invitation, and as a person who was lucky enough to use all the technologies, both open, thoracoscopic, robotoscopic, I want to convince you that robot is better. First and foremost, why we are doing this? In accordance with the global guidelines, minimally invasive surgery is a standard, while robot is one of minimally invasive procedures with high level of evidence. Look at what the pioneers of this field of surgery, how wise they were. They did not oppose robots to thoracoscopy. These are robotic manipulators, probably the better term, because this is a continuation of your hand. Franca Melfi wrote that this is a robotic technology for thoracoscopic surgery. And today this is a high-tech top achieved in this field of medicine in the world. I'm not going to show you the US slides because we're lagging behind a lot. In Russia we have 28 Da Vinci's and only in three centers RAS is being developed more or less. St. Petersburg, Krasnodar and Ufa. In spite of the fact that I've opened four centers in Russia, but unfortunately these technologies are not used much there. If we look at the global statistics, we have to recognize that only 3.7% of thoracic surgeries are performed in the overall volume of RATS, robotic-assisted surgeries. First and foremost, what is it all about? We have to comply with all the criteria of minimally invasive surgery and complete transformation of open surgery into minimally invasive surgery. Look at the surgery on the left, the open surgery, and on the right. You have two hands. You have a hand of your assistant. You have the same ergonomics of movements. What is paradoxical? The robot intuitively makes this surgical arm a continuation of your hand. You have a complete feeling of it being the continuation of your hand. A unique development, and we can't underestimate its benefits. You do not feel working with the instruments like scissors or forceps. Precisional isolation of the root elements and 3D visualization. 3D camera is very expensive in surgery. I will show you some slides where Diego Gonzalez Rivas is operating, one of the leaders of our thoracoscopic surgery, who is a very gifted surgeon. He is using a mechanical stabilizer for the camera. It's not the assistant who is holding the camera, which is very important. I know that the surgeons usually prefer to love with their eyes. That's why I'm showing so many videos. 7 degrees of freedom of the tools and the possibility of no support effect. A thoracic surgeon knows very well that we very often strive to be supported with someone. But look at how with the harmonic, we isolate very easily the commissures. TB cavern here, or what the surgeons usually frightened, but yesterday we had two lobectomies. One took us around 50 minutes, the other one 60. That was rough, but certainly the surgeons have to be experienced in this technique. On the other hand, please pay attention to the ergonomics of movements and how it is in work. On the left, we see Gonzalez Rivas. The surgeons, experienced surgeons always say, look at his left hand mainly, look at the camera, it is being held by the robot, by the manipulator, and look at the ergonomics of the robot. You are doing practically the same as you do with the, your scissors and forceps. And that's a thoracoscopic technique. And this is really important because it's all adds to the duration of the surgery, the result of the surgery, etc. There are no evidence of the robot's benefits. No meta-analysis. I refer to quite an old work of Robert Serfolio, who showed that rats is comparable with open surgery. Not that little. Efficacy and safety is the first stage to trust the technology. We see a little bit more lymph nodes. And I'll show you how we perform this. I always pay attention to the number of hands in the wound, two surgeons' hands and the assistant's hands. This video is quite longish. You see the vagus nerve, lymphodissection area, and this is a classical standard of lymphodissection in case of upper lobectomy. We perform it in all cases, and you will see brachycephalic stem, trachea, bronchi, pulmonary artery. Unfortunately, we can't accelerate the video, but R2 lymph node is seen very well. It is very important from the prognostic point of view. This is trachea already. And that's what we have in case of lymphodissection, standard lymphodissection, mind you. And first grade, the lung cancer, right, on the right. A few moments more. And that's the lymph node I've told you about. Here we are. And no lymph node. Okay, we're not finishing it. Let's go on. The most problematic for the robot is the seventh group of lymph nodes. Andrei is absolutely right. The techniques are not standardized. And to be honest, the most honest thoracoscopy is three-portal or triple-ports one. But in the Russian Federation, we prefer anterior access, which is very important, anterior approach. Rob Serfolio prefers posterior approach. The surgeons very rarely speak about this because we do not have to spend time on the isolation of interlobular fissures. And the seventh group is resected like this, so from posterior approach. You see groups 8 and 9, and you will see drainage in mediastinum now, and empty mediastinum after after video-assisted lymphodissection in mediastinum. You see drainages, and we have a free bifurcation area, which is very reliable. What is ROS from the point of view of evidence-based medicine? Unfortunately, as I've said, no meta-analysis, but look at the very short learning curve. If for thoracoscopy it's 50 or better, even 100 surgeries, and this is very difficult. ROS is much easier implemented into the clinic. Duration of the operation. We see the number of publications. And the more publications speak about the longer duration of RAS. But lobectomy never took us longer than 120 minutes. Well, thoracoscopy is 240, 280, 180 minutes. Intraop blood loss is more in video thoracoscopy, number of conversions, also more in video thoracoscopy, post-op complications. There are publications in favor of both, but in video thoracoscopy, there are more complications. Longer stay in hospital is longer in case of RAS. It's very difficult to explain why. Maybe it's connected with the clinic's traditions and other things, but not with the technology itself. And the main disadvantage of the robots are the costs. But As a surgeon, I've experienced different levels, and I must say that each new technology makes the surgery more expensive. Open surgery of dividing the interlobar fissures, maybe young surgeons even do not know how to perform this, but the new technologies are more expensive. And this is the greatest advantage of robotic operations, but there's one meta-analysis as of 2018 that showed that RADs are longer, but 30 days mortality is lower. Many reasons for that. Which patients to select for RADs lobectomy in first grade? First and foremost, those who are indicated to have lobectomy and for whom cancer is verified. Lobectomies up to 20% are performed in the Russian Federation only when cancer is suspected, 20%, because the technologies of invasive pulmonology to verify the diagnosis prior to surgery are not performed. This is a great, this is very sad. So we have to perform them only if cancer is verified. And look how we perform RADs. Four hands in the wound, mind you, very convenient. Yes, four punctures in the chest. And Vadim always tells me, why four? I perform only two. But the main thing is to do it in such a way that it would be safe and convenient for the patient. Usually our four punctures are not bad for the patient. In the evening of the day of the operation, the patients can usually stand up and walk and feel themselves quite okay. Central neuroendocrine cancer of the median lobe. And I must say that there's no better sewing machine in thoracic surgery than a robot. I would be glad to listen to Vitaly from Krasnodar, and it will be very interesting for me to listen that he, the person who masters robot-assisted technologies, performs thoracoscopies. Trust me, this is very, RADs is very efficient, ergonomic, safe. And we have performed it many times. As for the benefits, certainly ergonomics, 3D imaging, efficient work in small areas, especially mediastinum. Seventh group of lymph nodes is also quite narrow. If it is not a lower lobectomy on the right, on the left, but there are some difficulties there as well. No support effect, ambidextry, high maneuverability of the tools, etc. No tactile feedback is a minus. Non-sterile surgeon is remote from the patient, and certainly the price and the cost. What I want to pay attention to, thoracoscopic technologies have been conquering the world for 20 years. Robotic technologies have passed the same way in 10 years. I may suppose that this period will be accelerating. Why I'm so sure in this? Because two technologies will merge, thoracoscopic and robotic ones. And the first mechanoreceptor we discussed has been completed in 2016, but this is quite topical for peripheral non-verified masses. But that's how new thoracoscopic tools may look like. Very flexible tool. You may put it on your arm, 5 degrees of freedom. But look at what the surgeon is doing. Here there are many movements that are probably not that needed, that are a waste, because this is a very complicated device. In Dublin, about a week ago, Diego Gonzalez, who is a leader in terms of monoportal rods, presented the tests of such a robot that they are testing in the US together with Intuishift company. It means that conversion is not long to come. We have to implement the huge experience of thoracoscopic surgeons in robotic technologies. That's why very often we have engineers standing behind us, asking us what is more convenient for you, how better this is to be done, etc., etc. And this is, to my opinion, very convincing for everybody to believe that robots are our future. We have to master them, and we have to do everything for them to become cheaper. And I hope for the robotic group working in Moscow to reach these results. This will allow us to use this technique broader. This is my team, huge team, but no operation nurses or anesthesiologists here. But always we work as a team, and the assistant is performing very serious things, so they have to master all the technologies.